Good morning, everyone. It is Thursday, September 23rd, 2021. The Federal Reserve came out with their meeting yesterday. The market didn't move the way I thought it was going to move, but there's still some good opportunities, and we need to be patient to see if the market's going to continue with its uptrend or does it roll back over and start to hit new lows. Hi, my name is Jeff Tomasulo. I'm the co-founder of TacticalIncome.com and CEO of Espeley Capital Management. If you like what you see on these videos, please subscribe to our channel. Now, let's get to my computer screens and let's get to work. All right, guys, let's get to work. It is Thursday, September 23rd, 2021. It's about 8:09 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. And what a little week it's been, and we have finally have some of the events that I was waiting for, right? The Federal Reserve Bank met yesterday. You know, they came out with some hawkish comments and dovish comments, but really didn't give us any kind of clue on when the tapering's going to happen. They're saying probably November, but not how much. It wasn't as, you know, concise as I would have liked, right? And you saw that a little bit in the market. I mean, the market moved up, right? But it wasn't anything decisive yet. And I think that's something that's a little bit weighing on the overall market for possibly going higher or maybe even going lower. I don't know. But it wasn't anything that was clear enough to say, hey, this is what's going to happen. Very interesting, movement in the market. Again, we're going to go over that. We're going to go over some of the some trades that I see out there. But first, before I go through that, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, make comments, ask any question you want. I will get back to anybody that makes a comment, hopefully within 24 hours. And then also, I put a link in the description for the Tactical Income subscription service where we give out trade alerts, coaching calls, everything that you need to trade with an edge and to make money consistently. The tools are there and the support is there. Check us out. So on the Tactical Income trading platform right now, I have up the SPY. And I was on Reuters doing a TV interview on Tuesday talking about, hey, everybody, you know, and I talked to you guys about this on Tuesday too, is everybody's asking how far could the market go down? Is the market a buy after that one, you know, a 5% sell-off? And obviously no one knows, right? When you're in a situation when it finally starts to sell off, no one knows how far it's going to go. What I've saw over the course of my career is that anything I think is going to happen, it usually goes a lot further than I think, right? But there are clues, right? And I brought it up, hey, you know, you have the trend line, it broke that trend line. And then I'm going to bring up the 50-day moving average, which I think is really key, because why is it key? And now it's not the gospel out there, right? I'm trying to look at for what's working right now and what has worked in the past. And you can see, you know, using the power of observation, which we talk about all the time here, is that every time it came to the 50-day moving average, it held, or if it broke through, it was back above it. I mean, pretty consistently over the last year and a half, right? So that is a clue that, hey, you know, it usually holds it or breaks it. If it breaks it, it could go a lot further. And then on top of that, you bring the trend line. So you had a double whammy, right? It broke the 50-day moving average. It broke the trend line. So how do you use that to your advantage? Well, hey, we saw that the market came in, and I talk about this all the time. Forget about people's opinions. Look at price and volume. And what is price and volume? Well, price is up here and volume is down here, right? You saw very heavy, and this line right here is the average volume, right, for over the course of the year. So anything above that, you're saying, hey, this is pretty significant. Anything below it, you're like, all right, not so significant. Well, we got some significant days over the last week, right, of selling. Look how the down volume was much greater than the green volume. Right, so that's given me a little clue that even on the up move that we had yesterday, it was still above the average, but not as significant as it was, on the down day. Now, on top of that, I say to myself, listen, this can still be a short. I'm not leaning that way. I mean, I'm leaning that way a little bit, but I'm still saying, hey, what we've seen over the course of the last year and a half, right? And more than that, I mean, over the last 5-6 years, any kind of major dip is bought, right? And, you know, of 3 to 5%. So yes, we're getting this buy-in, but I'm going to see how it reacts. Can it get over, especially in the SPY, can it get over the 50-day moving average, and can it hold above that, right? So when I'm thinking about my capital allocation and I'm looking to put money to work, well, I'm not going to be totally going full, you know, my full amount of money that I normally would, my full position sizes, all right? I'm going to test the waters per se, right? I'm going to go a quarter, a half of my position size until I start to get some confirmation that this downtrend is, or this down move is done, and we're back into an uptrend, right? You're just being smart with how you're going to allocate your capital. It doesn't mean you can't put trades on, but the type of trades, the strategies that I'm going to put on are more defined risk than open risk, right? I'm being very tight with my directional trades. You know, that's the kind of thought process that I'm having until this changes, and I'm looking for the clues, right? I'm going to see if we have an update today. We're opening up, right? The S&P 500 is up 0.5%. And if it continues to go higher, is it doing it on higher volume? Does it break the 50-day moving average? Right, yesterday, right, we'll go to the QQQs, same thing. It had this big down move. Look at the volume, massive volume. Now the two up days that we're seeing had over the average, and now we're getting above the 50-day moving average, right? So can it hold? Can it continue? If it starts to continue, I start to lean more to the long side than the possible short side. If it fails, right, if it starts to go down and we have a negative day today, well, that's a sign and of something has changed where I'm going to start leaning more to the short side and also not put as much capital to work to wait to see how the market plays out. So that's kind of my thought process on, you know, the NASDAQ and the S&P. Now, the IWM I find very interesting. And we've talked about this to the point where I know you guys are freaking sick of it because I'm kind of sick of it. But the IWM has gone down the most, right? It is from, you know, the 52-week high to where we saw the low on Monday. It was down almost close to 9%. That's a pretty big move, but it wasn't at its all-time highs either, right? So it's hovering in this range here. So to me, if the market starts to turn and go up, right? The IWM, I'm going to obviously get long it because it's above its 50-day moving average, but I want to go see if it can become the new leader. Now, we've tried this numerous times. I've talked about this numerous times. I've lost too much money in this freaking thing. However, I've kept it, you know, I'm going to put money to work to see if it can become the leader. And if it can't, well, maybe, you know, the rest of the markets pull it up and maybe it does go and you make some decent money in it. But it's something that it is something I'm watching because it's acting different than the other indices, right? It held into this massive consolidation range, you want to call it, that it's been in for the last, since basically February. So something to keep an eye on. The Dow is exactly the same as everything else, right? It's especially the SPY had a massive down move. The question, can it really rally back up and stay, you know, get back into this area? It broke its trend line. So same kind of thought process in the Dow. I don't usually trade the Dow as much as the other, you know, three indices. I don't know why. It's a great question. I gotta delve more into that on why I don't. You know, just something that, you know, this is some food for thought. And this is kind of what I'm looking at. This is what I said on Reuters. Is really kind of play off of that, the 50-day moving average and the trend lines. And then obviously look at the individual stocks that we talk about all the time that make this up, right? Like the FANG stocks, how are they acting? You know, the different stocks that I listed on Tuesday, you know, and they're acting pretty well. And we're going to go through some of them right now. So let's go through some of the stocks that I'm watching, right? I've been watching the whole time. Facebook was one of them that came out with news. And this got hit really hard yesterday. It's trading up 1% today. How do you play Facebook? Well, you know, it's that type of news, right? When it comes out, you really don't know how far it's going to go. But I love this type of trade. You know, hey, you know, my attitude is you put a little capital to work, you use a defined risk trade, You sell a put spread in here because it's one of the leaders, right? It's been one of those leaders. So on these pullbacks where you get 10% down moves, and it is definitely off 10% from its high. It's down even more than that. You try to put some capital work, and you give yourself some time. And what I mean by time, duration. And we, you know, I put a trade in, and I sent out the trade alert to our subscribers in BI, in Alibaba, right? And you know, this is a stock that's getting beat up, and people are asking me why would you put a trade on in here? Well, you know what? I'm gonna give myself 50 something days. I'm gonna define the risk, and I'm gonna see what happens over 50 something days, right? I think it was 56 days. That's why I'm saying 50 something. I just don't remember if it was 56, 57. You know, I sold a put spread, and over 50 days, I know I'm risking the width of the spread minus the premium I received. And if it works out, I receive the premium. I bring some income into my portfolio, but I let the market and it figure itself out. I can't control what the market is going to do. I can't control what a stock can do. But what I can control is the type of strategy I put on, the risk I take, right? And that's pretty much all I can kind of control in this. And then when I take it off, right? So, you know, I like these type of trades where in Facebook, you know, you get this down move. Everybody's like, oh, do I buy it? Do I not buy it? Well, you know what? You can allocate a little bit of capital and make some money, right? It doesn't have to be the end all be all where I have to go all in and make a massive chop, right? It is, you know, you can do that, right? If you really believe in Facebook and you think this is a long-term buy and you're a long-term buyer, well, yeah, maybe you buy it in here, but you could put on multiple strategies, right? To take advantage of this down move. But right now, to me, it's a flip of a coin whether it can go down further or up further. No one knows, right? So make sure you put on the right strategy, risk the right amount of capital, and then you let it play out because you have no control over that, right? So that's Facebook. Another stock that I've been watching. I missed this because I was waiting for, I thought we were gonna get a little bit of a bigger sell-off the way the market was acting. And a lot of these stocks, I mean, my subscribers will tell you they didn't get many alerts from me because I was expecting, especially on a lot of those stocks I was following, kind of pissed at myself because I should have put some stuff to work, some capital to work. But you know, Bowen is one of these stocks that I like, and you can see that it's holding this area down here, and it showed me some really interesting move yesterday. You can see it's holding it here. It's coming down to its 50-day move above. Right up into its 50-day moving average, but it's in this little range, and you saw the volume tick up on it yesterday. You know, my hesitation was only because I thought I was going to get better prices as the market, you know, maybe continued to sell off. But this is a stock that I kind of like. You have a little bit, you have an area where you're like, holy cow, I know anything below this, yes, it's going to probably head lower, but it's holding in this area right here, and it's looking good. And it's a lot of these reopening trades, right? The airlines love, right? We've talked about this, you know, over and over, a couple weeks ago. You're starting to see how they try to come down to these levels, and now it's making higher lows, and it's starting to break above its 50-day moving average. I mean, this is a stock where you can buy the call spreads, you can buy, you know, you can buy the stock outright, and you know, take some risk on, and have a possible great, you know, a pretty decent move up. I mean, the upside is pretty, it can go pretty good amount, right? If you know, we come out, we pull it out a little further. I mean, that's looking like a really nice little chart. Same thing in UAL. They all look the same. We go to AAL. I mean, that stock looks pretty much the same also. So you're gonna get some good opportunities in here in some of these stocks. You know, Hilton I like only because it was looked like it was breaking out of this nice big range we talked about, and now it's kind of holding in there. So, you know, there are going to be opportunities. It's just, are we going to get the follow through with the overall market? But the stocks that are holding up are the stocks that I'm showing you right now. Coinbase held up extremely well during that little sell off, right? Like in you know, that Bitcoin made a move down to 40,000 during the little sell-off, and yeah, Coin came in, but it's kind of holding there. These are some of these stocks that I like. Goldman Sachs, right? It comes down, it breaks down, comes into this this little range in here where you find some of that support. Watch what I'm gonna draw this line. Boom, right in here, right? So you see that it's bouncing, you know, it had a couple days of up here. The question is, we're kind of in, you know, a little bit of no man's land where, you know, you could, this is, and let's play out this scenario, right? You could buy these stocks here. If the market rolls over, you're in a little bit of a, you know, a little bit of like, oh shit, I'm gonna lose money, right? And you're not in a position of strength. You're not in a position to weakness, but you're not in a great position yet, right? You didn't get any consolidation. That's why I hate when the market goes down, you get these V bottoms. But these are stocks that, hey, again, if I was putting capital to work, I should have been looking to sell put spreads into here, right? But I can, you know, the market was coming off. I thought we could go off a little bit higher. I didn't pull the trigger. It happens, right? I'm not going to beat myself up about it, but now I'm going to be patient and not make any bad decisions. Another stock that's waking up, a couple stocks. Now, you know, I put alerts out there in my system and it alerts me, like Tilray. You know, it got upgraded, right? These are stocks that used to be high flyers that when I start to see them move again, I'm always just watching because you never know, right? You never know how, if they're going to wake up and really go. Another one that came out on alert today was BlackBerry, right? It's trading up over 8% today. And, you know, there's news on it, you know, so when, you know, it got better than it was their earnings. I'm sorry, news. It was the earnings. It's right in front of my face. It had better than expected results. Roku is another one that I really like. That got upgraded this morning. It kind of had a massive sell-off, and now it's starting to break out. What could you do here? Buy call spreads, buy the stock outright if you're willing to take on, you know, 10% of risk right down here, right? So there are definitely some stocks. Another one, Plug, right? This is a stock that got upgraded today. It's been in this big consolidation pattern. Is this the time where it starts to move and starts to make its way, you know, have a bigger up move, right? You can see the move that it had, or is it going to just sit in there? But these are things that you have to put on your watch list because there's going to be some great opportunities in there. So guys, listen, I hope you like this video. I went a little longer than I kind of wanted to, but I hope the information that you're getting is going to give you some opportunities to make money or save yourself some money. So check out the link that I put in for the Tactical Insom subscription service. You get trade alerts, coaching calls, you get access to a proprietary algorithm, the vol meter, which helps you pinpoint stocks and asset classes that give you a higher probability of profit and success. And you get access to the Tactical Income trading platform, which is invaluable on so many different levels. It's just so easy to navigate and give you all the information that you need. But check us out. And remember, guys, when trading, trade with an edge, and I'll talk to you guys soon.